Castellet is Spain's undisputed queen of snowboarding. The four-time Olympian and triple X Games medalist has been an elite competitor specializing in halfpipe for more than a decade. Castellet soared and twisted her way to a silver medal at the Granada 2015 Winter Universiade. It was an extra special performance coming on home snow in the scenic Sierra Mountains of southern Spain. Castellet demonstrated her resilience after an uncharacteristic first run crash, rebounding with a superb second act that catapulted her to silver. Now 32, Castellet is seeking a trip to a fifth Olympic Games in Beijing. It would be a major accomplishment coming alongside her USA halfpipe counterpart, the legendary Shaun White. You might say it would be a high-flying Spanish fiesta. Hello and welcome to another edition of the FISU University Legends interview series. I'm Brian Pinelli. And joining me now, all the way from Copper Mountain, Colorado, where she is training for the season opening World Cup event, is the Spanish snowboarder, Queralt Castellet. Hola, Queralt.
Hola, buenas tardes, buenos días. I don't know.
That's about all the Spanish I have, but I wanted to be polite. But then again, you are in the United States right now, so we probably should speak English. Is that okay with you?
We can speak English. I am thankful for this amazing introduction. That was very cool.
Thank you very much. Muchas gracias. Yeah. So tell me, we're a couple days away from the World Cup season opener. Obviously, an important Olympic season with the Beijing Winter Games a couple months away. You've been down this road before, preparing for four Olympic Games. This could be your fifth. I guess, first off, Queralt, how are things going for you in Colorado? How are you feeling? And are you excited to get the season started?
Very much so. To be honest, I'm so grateful that I got to start the season and start the contest. I remember at this time last year, such a normal event for us to keep the season that is like always almost a ritual is the Copper Grand Prix had to be canceled last year. Yeah. Due to all the circumstances and not just that, but many others. So just grateful that we're here and that that the contests are happening and we are riding and we can snowboard and the mountains are open and the ski fields are running. So it was awesome that we could ride during the preseason as well in autumn.
Kind of amazing. If I'm correct, your first World Cup event was in Chile back in 2005. As mentioned, you have the three X Games medals, a world championship silver in Austria prior to the Granada 2015 Universiade. Such great competitors in your sport. You know, Chloe Kim, obviously the defending Olympic champion, a couple Chinese rivals that you have, a great contingent of Japanese athletes. What keeps you motivated after all these years with such improving competition year in and year out?
I mean, you kind of said it yourself. I've seen, so the riders that you mentioned now, the riders that are on heat now, but I've been here before them and I have seen many riders that have been dominating this discipline. And I kind of have been included in this pack from the beginning. And I see a lot of them arrive and leave and come and go. And I've always been there. So what keeps me motivated? The fact that I keep pushing it and I keep pushing everyone that comes in and I'm a part of it, I'm joining it and I'm enjoying it. It's just, to me, it's not a job. It's not an obligation. It's just an opportunity that I get to enjoy every day. And it's amazing. Every day that I get that I'm on my snowboard, I'm just having fun, and that's what's it.
Queralt, I find it absolutely amazing, and of course, wish you the best of luck here in the final lead up to the Beijing Winter Games, which would be your fifth. And we mentioned Sean White at the top. The legendary American snowboarder is also seeking a fifth Olympic Games. He has 3 Olympic gold medals. I know your best finish was in Pyeongchang 4 years ago, I believe 7th.
Yeah, it's a bit different because he kind of he medaled way more times than I. But yeah, it's amazing. We're good friends. We kind of have this this friendly relationship that we know that we've been here for a long time, and you know, we've seen that before, and we still kicking it and ripping it. So it's pretty cool.
Kicking it and ripping it. I like it. What would it mean for you to represent Spain at a fifth Olympic Games in Pyeongchang? I believe your snowboard cross colleague, Regino Hernandez, became the first Olympic medalist in snowboarding for Spain. What would it mean for you to go to a fifth Olympic Games? And do you feel at this stage of your career, I know you've been snowboarding well despite Corona the past few seasons, what would it take to potentially contest for medals there in Beijing, where many athletes are headed for the first time?
Yeah, well, to me, to represent Spain in the Olympics is always, I always approach it as an opportunity to showcase my sport. And it's not a pressure, but it's a honor to be showing what snowboarding is to the rest of the world. And you know, the Olympics is the event that is more people watch, more people see it, so more people get to see what I do. And to me, it's amazing to have this opportunity. Yet it is true too that every time I enter a competition, this you know, it's with the goal to medal. So the Olympics is no different, and I'm always there to rock it.
All right.
Give it my best. Yeah.
Looking forward to seeing you rock it there in Beijing, approaching quickly in what's been a challenging time for all of sport. I want to go back a couple of years, obviously, to your Winter Universiade experience, Granada 2015. You're there on home snow in the beautiful Sierra Mountains there in southern Spain, and you're competing as a student athlete. And we should mention you were competing as a student athlete, but Queralt, you had already been to 3 Olympic Games, so obviously you had a multitude of experience. And to, you know, and I realize you'd had so much success before, but to stand on a podium, you know, there in Spain as, you know, as essentially a host of the event or one of the hosts of the event. Do you recall the feelings on that day?
Yeah. It was a lot of emotions because even though Sierra Nevada is not my home mountain, I felt like it kind of was. And I felt like all the riders thought it was. So I kind of felt this proud feeling of like, you know, I hope you guys like it. Like, this is Spain. This is my home. And yeah, and I was stoked that it was good weather and that everyone was having such a blast, because really also one cool thing about the university games is that the vibe, it's different than all the others. You know, it's just a bit more friendly, a bit more laid back, and way more fun orientated. So that was very cool.
Now, you're originally from Barcelona, if I understand correctly. What about your university studies, Queralt? You were studying at University of La Rioja. I'm mispronouncing it.
Actually, I started the UOC, which is the like University in Catalonia that you can do online. And I started studying marketing because it was a way to study abroad and keep studying. I wasn't sure really what I wanted to do, but the fact that I was really involved in like branding and sponsorships and all that, I thought it was like really beneficial for me to start studying about that. But after a couple of years, I found that really didn't quite interest me in itself. So I changed to international business, because at this time I was living in New Zealand. So I was like, maybe, you know, I can learn a thing or two if I start this linked career. And yeah, I did learn, I liked it, but I really started to focus a lot on my snowboarding. And at this time, I just couldn't keep it on. I didn't have time and I didn't have energy for it. So I kind of have to slowly step away a little bit and say to myself, okay, sadly, I don't have time for that.
Hey, Carol, want to look back a little bit. Of course, snowboarding made its Olympic debut all the way back in Nagano 98. So I believe Beijing will be the seventh time around. I mean, it started basically with just half pipe. Now we have slope style and big air and cross. I mean, other events, I mean, also, I know you're focused on half pipe, but have these other events also interested you? And I guess my second question is, how important is it for the sport to keep growing with new events and more competitions?
Yeah, it's huge. And as you said, the half pipe is the oldest one. And that's basically why I focused on half pipe. But at the time when there was competitions for the Olympics, it was kind of like border cross or half pipe, like racing or freestyle. And freestyle was half pipe. And I wanted to do freestyle, whether it was jumping, whether it was doing rails, whether it was doing half pipe, I didn't mind. But at the time, half pipe was the thing. And it required a lot of practice that then also, you know, helped me in all the other disciplines, including the snowboarding. So I think one key to be a good half pipe rider is to be a good snowboarder in all terrains. So I never stopped riding all sorts of snowboarding and disciplines in the snowboarding, like besides racing, that this I didn't do anymore. But I actually, for the last Olympics, I did qualify for big air because I did a couple of years. I did the tour of the doing the big airs, a part of the half pipe. And even though at the beginning it was a bit hard because it was pretty scary to me, it was like a challenge that it made me grow and it made me learn a lot. So.
Well, thank you for taking the time today out of your busy training schedule with the season right upon us there, Queralt. Best of luck this season and also in your pursuit of a fifth Olympic Games come Beijing in February. We wish you the best of luck and all the success in the world.
Thank you so much.
And thank you for tuning in to this edition of the FISU University Legends Interview Series. I'm Brian Pennelly. Look forward to seeing you down the road where we profile more Universiade athletes who have gone on to bigger and better things both on and off the field of play. Have a great day, everybody. Muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias.